Hey, what's happening, guys? Welcome back. Welcome back. This is going to be a quick fight recap video. UFC 273. I'm going to cover Volkanovski versus Korean Zombie, Gilbert Burns versus Khamzat Chimaev, and Petr Yan versus Aljamain Sterling. So let's start with that one. Petr Yan versus Sterling. Well, the decision, I can't say that I entirely agree with. Aljamain Sterling did have great control in rounds 2 and 3. He was threatening with the rear naked choke with a submission. Had the body triangle on Petr Yan, who couldn't get out. Petr Yan, to his credit, did defend well. That's a strong position for Aljamain Sterling. Most guys, he would have finished in that position. The fact that Petr Yan basically went 2 rounds in that position and survived is a testament to how good his BJJ defense is and his composure. So 2 big rounds for Aljamain Sterling. Now, I have to rewatch the fight. I do think that Petr Yan, thinking about it right now, won rounds 1, 4, and 5, in my opinion. There's no question 4 and 5. Now, my overall judgment of the fight, I felt like Petr Yan definitely in control of the stand-up. Aljamain did land some shots, but I really didn't see Petr Yan flopping around all over the place. Aljamain didn't look good in a lot of those exchanges. He was on his knees, reaching kind of like in a submissive position. Looked like kind of like survival mode. I have to look at the stats. The fights are officially judged round by round, but my overall thought of the fight, I do think Petr Yan edged it out. I want to emphasize edged. Wasn't mad at the Aljamain decision at all. I just think Petr Yan won. Again, rounds 1, 4, and 5. That's just me. Moving on to Khamzat Chimaev versus Gilbert Burns. Well, I just want to say the hype is real. What a great fight. What a war. Hype is real for Khamzat. Gilbert Burns, what a warrior. Hats off to Gilbert Burns, man. Those two guys threw down. Threw caution to the wind. I did agree with the decision, but it was really close. I mean, honestly, it could have went either way. Gilbert Burns did a lot of damage. Khamzat, overall, I do think he was more dominant in the fight. If you notice, when Khamzat slowed things down, used his jab and his technical striking, used his reach, he had so much more success. When he engaged in a slugfest with Gilbert, that's when he was running into problems. Khamzat kept looking for that uppercut. That thing is kind of like a trademark of his. I did a striking analysis video a little bit ago. Actually covered that uppercut. It's nasty, and he tried to catch Gilbert Burns with that thing often. But he was leaving himself open. Gil was countering well, landing big shots, big overhands. My honest impression of Khamzat is that he's dangerous. He's very skilled. He is an elite fighter. Definitely proved himself tonight. Gilbert Burns is number 2. He's no joke. And he gave him a run for his money and won via decision. But he has to tighten up. Because if he fights like that against Usman, he's going to have a rough night. Covington's a different story. Kobe doesn't really have power like that. I actually think that Khamzat would give Kobe issues. But Usman's another story. This is a great learning experience for Khamzat. The only problem is that going forward, he's going to fight elites now. So he better tighten up quick. Fight smarter. Fight more technical. And he has to improve his defense. Both of these guys won, in my opinion. Khamzat proved himself. Burns further proved himself that he's a warrior. Moving on to Volkanovski versus Korean Zombie. Damn, I felt bad for Korean Zombie. He simply was outgunned. I'm not going to say outskilled, because he's very skilled. But Volkanovski was just faster, more explosive, more physically conditioned. To me, Korean Zombie looked a little bit out of shape. He looked softer. I've seen him way more ripped, more muscular, bigger than that. I don't know what was going on with Zombie. Maybe he was injured. Not trying to make excuses for him, because I did have Volkanovski winning. But maybe it's just Korean Zombie slowing down. It happens to every fighter. He definitely looks a little bit older. Age creeps up on everybody, as well as the wars. Everyone ages differently. Could be a combination of Volkanovski just being a bad man and Korean Zombie slowing down a little bit. Because the Zombie that I know has wicked fast reflexes, awesome counters, super slick striking, and he's fast. Zombie looked considerably slower to the punch compared to Volkanovski. That was the main factor to me. Volkanovski's speed, his aggression, and explosiveness. Zombie was trying to fight slick, trying to find his shots, fighting very loosey-goosey, leaving his chin out there, which is classic Zombie. But Volkanovski was just putting a stamp on those punches. He was firing with bad intent, a lot of speed, a lot of power. Those things were connecting and doing massive damage. It was a good stoppage. Zombie's too tough for his own good. Herb Dean, for as much crap as he gets, great job tonight, Herb, with that fight. Definitely stopped it at the right time. I was thinking about Ferguson versus Gaethje. If they only did that for Tony. Because it was looking a lot like that fight. Beatings like that not only take years off of your career, they take years off of your life. And I like Korean Zombie a lot. It was heartbreaking to see him crying in the octagon. If it's his last fight, damn. Thank you so much, Zombie, for all the entertaining fights. Definitely one of my favorite fighters to watch compete. Salute, sir. Salute. Volkanovski, animal. Who's stopping that guy? The only one that has a chance is Max Holloway. Why not? Let him fight again. Anyway, guys, let me know what you thought about these three matches. What did you think of the results? What were your impressions of the fights? We'd love to read your opinions. If this is your first time at the channel and you enjoy the content that you see, hit that subscribe button. Like and share as that helps support the channel. Appreciate that, and I'll catch you guys on the next segment. Until then, take care, guys.